It was early spring, and Ryan Taboada and his family were looking forward to their vacation.
I've been working pretty hard, you know, long hours and stuff every week, and we really needed to get away. And it was the first time that I was actually feeling, like, really good. Like, I didn't have any weight on my shoulder other than just to have some fun.
They decided to take a road trip to visit relatives in Virginia.
That was our first trip ever since we arrived here in the States. That was a very exciting thing for us, going state to state and driving, seeing so much places that we haven't seen before. Everything is new.
But we're just probably going to stay at the hotel.
So we basically took our time. We let our cousin know that we were going to be a little bit later in the evening when we arrived there in Virginia.
It was nearly 2 a.m. when the Taboadas decided to check into a motel.
I was kind of tired and had been driving all day, so I said, well, you know, this one looks pretty good. We'll stay here. It wasn't as well lit as I usually like, but we just decided to park right there in front of the office, feeling that that was the safest place to be.
The kids were sleeping, so we decided we would just check in and come back for them and the stuff. It never occurred to me that it wasn't safe there. Never.
After checking in, Leelin woke up the kids while Ryan got their bags.
And then Ryan took one bag and he was shouting like, ooh. And then I looked at him because I thought there was like a snake or something, any animals that might scare him. And then I heard shots. And then I saw a man holding a gun. And I was screaming, stop, please stop, the kids are here, please, please. And he just continued on.
I didn't really even remember hearing anything, but I felt like something hot hit me in the back. And then I turned around and there was somebody there, you know, shooting. He shot a couple more times, so I was trying to shield myself with the duffel bag that I was carrying.
And I saw Ryan, he was struggling, you know. He was trying to cover himself. We, like, told the kids to, like, bow down your heads.
What? Take my car, take my wallet, and take anything you want!
Assumed that we were being mugged, and I told him to take whatever he wanted just to leave us alone. It wasn't really in a state to be reasoned with, so I charged at him with the bag in front of me and tried to get him away from the vehicle. I was just really concerned about my family. I just wanted to get him away. He went down right where the gun was, so he turned around and shot me again. That's when he hit me in the neck, and I went down. Then he continued to shoot and shoot. The magazine was done, he reloaded and just kept shooting.
Leelin watched in horror as the gunman shot Ryan 16 times at point-blank range. She knew that she and the children would be his next targets. Ryan and Leelin Taboada had just checked into a motel late one night. As Ryan unloaded their bags, a crazed gunman opened fire, shooting Ryan 16 times. Leelin and their two children watched helplessly from inside their SUV.
And I was, like, in a state of shock. I was really scared he might shoot the rest of us also. And that's when I ran for help. I was freaking out and scared.
As the night manager called 911, Leelin noticed her son standing outside the door.
My son was able to run after me. When he knocked on that door, he was so pale. He was like trembling and shaking and so scared.
Hearing gunshots, a guest ran into the lobby.
The guy just got shot.
Just then, Leelin was horrified to see the gunman take off in their SUV with their daughter, Veronica, still in the back seat.
My baby's in the car! So I ran out. The truck wasn't there, and I knew my daughter was there. I went crazy. And that's when I saw Ryan. He was really dead. For me, he was dead. I knelt down and held his hand and was, you know, right.
Police spotted the SUV near the motel and began a high-speed pursuit. Minutes later, the gunman lost control and crashed on the side of the road where police arrested him. They determined that he was high on drugs and had been looking to steal a car. They found Veronica still in her seat, scared but unharmed. Back at the motel, an ambulance arrived and paramedics began treating Ryan.
And I kept asking them, is he still alive, you know? And then I saw the police coming in and I was begging them, please help me. And I was screaming for my daughter.
The police told her that her daughter was safe, but she needed proof.
And they brought me my daughter.
Miraculously, Ryan was still alive. He was rushed to a nearby hospital where he was treated for multiple injuries, including two collapsed lungs, a broken neck, and a severed nerve, which left his right side partially paralyzed.
Every doctor that I go to says that it's a miracle. I went to a neurosurgeon. He looked at the x-rays and he just said, I'm surprised you're standing here in front of me.
Since the shooting, Ryan and Leelin have taken other vacations, but now they always call ahead to make sure a security guard is on duty.